We murmur, complain about things. We tell God he don't know how to what? Take care of us. Here we go again. He said that as the people complained, the Lord heard it. Do you not think that every time you complain, God don't hear it? I see Sister Odessa look up and say, yes, yes, yes. He hears it. And it is an insult. Understand something. I'm not talking about a president. I'm talking about a king. It is an insult to tell the king that he don't know how to take care of you. Because the king's reputation is based on how well his what? Citizens are taken care of. So what happened was this. As the children of Israel began to complain, moment now, early on, he said, my name shall be on this people. When they was told his name, what it means is this. Could you say it over there? You're the children of Israel. He's an outside nation. You are murmuring and complaining about the Lord. He hears it. He represents the nation. He hears it. And he said, I don't want no parts of that part. He hears you. The people that you are around hears you. When you got a lot of stuff going on, a lot of confusion going on in the church, and you take it to work and say, they getting on my nerve at church, they give me, they hear you. And then as soon as you have family and friends there, you go back and try to invite that person to church. Don't want no parts of it. Amen? Don't want no parts of it. And see, God had to deal with this because they were now producing another culture. They were beginning now to see, you understand something? The children of Israel have been in Egypt for a while. Egypt had a what? Culture. They had a culture in Egypt also. And that's what God was trying to get out of them. That's why he had it over there. We skipped over Leviticus. That's why the Leviticus laws came. Because the people had been so far and absent from God until they did not understand and know the home country's culture no more. So he had to give them the laws so that they might understand again who this Yahweh is. From the time of the fall of Adam on, the people just progressed further and further and further away from Yahweh, our God. It says that the Lord's anger was kindled greatly against these people. Because why? They were causing other people to not want a part of God. Understand something now. He never left his original intent. He wanted to rule the seen from the unseen. He wanted to rule the seen earth from the unseen heaven. He was still trying to influence a group of people through this vessel called Moses. Because he needed a what? Body. Needed a body. So that's what he was trying to do. So as they begin to murmur and complain, they said the fire of the Lord burnt among them. The word fire of the Lord means that the presence of the Lord burnt among them. See, the presence of the Lord can come in one of two ways. Now, when you read and talk about the presence of the Lord is not always a good presence. You see, when the Lord comes in his presence to bless you, but also the Lord can come with his presence to deal with you. He came down because he wanted to deal with them, because he didn't want this to infect the rest of the people. Good illustration, Holy Ghost, good illustration. You go to Walmart and you buy a flat screen TV. And that flat screen TV works for about 3 months, and then it blows up. You take that flat screen TV back to Walmart, and you tell them, I had this for 3 months, and it blowed up. They say, well, nothing we can do about that. You didn't send the warranty papers, blah, blah, blah. You said, if you don't deal with this flat screen TV, I'm going to the local newspaper, I'm going to call the local television station, I'm going to voice my complaint to them. What do you think Walmart going to do? They're going to make sure you're a satisfied customer. Why? Because they don't want their reputation to be in the media as a bad place. The same way with God. He said, when you walk upright before me, he said, I guarantee you, your life will be great. I guarantee you. So God was telling the people this stuff. You're not going to make me look bad. I can't let this happen. I'm working towards something and I want to use you all. But my anger now, you cause me to get angry. Now the presence, my presence is coming down, but it's not for your good. It's a kingdom. You see what Moses did? Moses began to what? Begin to pray. Moses began to pray. And Moses prayed unto the Lord, and the fire was what? Quenched. The fire was quenched. He was put out. Moses calmed him down. Moses would say things to him like, these people that you have brought out here. See, Moses knew the heart of God. He knew. Why? He knew God's purpose for Israel. If you're going to follow somebody, you got to make sure you follow somebody that knows God's purpose. Because if somebody knows God's purpose, they know how to get in contact with God. Moses knew that God's purpose was that he wanted to gain all nations unto himself. So Moses began to pray and he said, God, how would it look if you destroy this people and these other nations are looking? And they'll say, they don't want no parts of that God. Now murmur is bad. But if you destroy him, it's going to be worse than that murmur. Because the king has to have a body. Moses has a bone. Not because he's so great, but because God was what? Man. God was man. And Moses knew this because he was one that talked to God face to face. Face to face. Not like this. Such a personal relationship. That it was face to face. Sister came up last week. She had an awesome question. She said, I thought that the scripture said that no man can see his face and live. And we went through a study right here. I love when somebody wants to inquire a word. I love that.